It will be a wild afternoon here in Newark, New Jersey, home of the 2013 NHL Draft. And we welcome you inside the draft floor anytime you get 30 general managers as well as their head coaches and all their scouts together. Things will happen. For more on who might go number one and who might go after, let's send it upstairs to Gordon Miller and the draft panel, guys.
All right, James, thank you. To underline the importance of the National Hockey League draft, when Chicago won the cup last week, the Hawks had 12 of their own drafted players in the lineup. When New Jersey won the last cup in 2003 for the Devils, they had 14. So obviously this is where championship teams are built.
This is gonna, yeah. This draft grid is gonna be our list at the table. Okay. So when we're crossing guys off and, you know, Colorado takes McKinnon, this is the list that we're gonna be crossing off.
So
what we're gonna do is we're just gonna go over it just briefly. We're not really gonna make a lot of changes. We've done our work already, and if there's guys that you don't like in a certain position, just, you know, make sure you voice your opinion and we can go from there. So
what about the we talked about character. I mean, Schneid saw a guy a lot. He really didn't like him, but he's still on there. I'm a little, I mean, if they're there in the first, we take him. I mean, with,
well, I
if
think
character is important, then
yeah,
I'm getting a mixed message, to be honest.
Well, we just can't discredit a kid just because he's, you mean, at the end of the day, they're still kids, and
yep,
there's a lot of growing up, I think, to do. They're, some guys are maybe not as good as other guys potentially could be because of character, but I think,
you know, if you have guys in the first round, to me, you can't make mistakes. That's my own. I just hope we don't end up with those guys. That's all I'm saying.
Well, I think they're in a position where we're not going to get them anyways. You mean, and I think when we have these lateral grids and stuff like that, that's really to guard against that too.
Cool.
Wennberg?
Yeah, Wennberg, two way forward. First season with man, and this year he scored, but last year the junior team, he didn't score much. But it was hard to believe it because he has very good hands, and he had so many chances. And this year he finally scored. I think he's the guy. He will be the same every game, you know, a responsible two-way player who can score.
Consistent.
Good size, good skating.
Really good skater.
Yeah.
Really good.
Wennberg's a guy that I think could slide possibly to us, and he's got an element I think that we drastically need in Columbus. Top six guy.
The one thing that I've always found interesting too is that somebody might have Domi in top five, top six, and then they'll have somebody ahead of them when they pick, and then the next three teams don't have him until 20.
Yeah.
So he slides.
Same as
and then the next team has him at six, but they still have their fifth guy available, so they take that, and so it's interesting how he can slide. But you don't make the order based on who you're going to get, where you're going to get. You make the order based on who you want first.
You have any questions on Wennberg?
No.
He's here Saturday, right? Wennberg?
No, Friday.
Oh, Friday.
At 1 o'clock tomorrow. So what we're going to do with the interview process, the four or five guys that we're going to interview, the guys from that region are going to be in on that. So Nick and Milan be in with Wennberg.
How you doing?
Alex.
Hey, good to
see you
again.
Nice to
see you.
Hi, Alex. Good to see you
again. Nice to meet you.
Okay.
Hi,
Milan.
Alex, nice to
meet
you.
John Davidson.
Alex, nice to
see you.
So if you were to compare yourself to one, to somebody in the NHL right now, who would you compare yourself to?
I would say Nicklas Bäckström in Washington. Because I think he's a smart player on the ice, he's great handling the puck, and he's a great playmaker. I may be more like a fast kid than he is on the ice, but I think a part of our game is pretty similar. So.
pretty good player.
Yeah, absolutely.
So if everything worked out the exact way that you would think in the next couple of years, kind of run that timeline for us. You go to for London next year, you play, and...
Yeah, the thing is, I'm going to take it a little bit year after year in Finland. I signed a two-year contract, but the big dream for me is always to play in NHL. So this year I'm going to get ready, like improve my skills, get bigger, stronger, and gain some weight, and see if I'm ready for the NHL. And after that, like I said, I always want to play in NHL and want to be a big player over there. So this year in Finland, and maybe another year, work hard to get ready. And after that, I want to like be a big part of an NHL team. So,
where do you think you're going to go in this draft?
I don't really know. Of course, I know about the rankings and what you ranked on Craigslist and all this kind of stuff. But to be honest, I'm not really sure. I can end up everything from 10 to 30 or something. So for me, I think this is the big opportunity to get drafted, and I'm just hoping that I'm going to the right team that believes in me and wants to play me.
You know where we're picking?
Not exactly numbers, but three first round pick, right?
14, 19, and 27. Right. Should we use one of those on you? Which one?
14, of course.
Well, enjoy the week.
Thank you.
It's an exciting time for you and your family.
Absolutely. Okay.
Good luck.
Thanks. Nice meeting you.
You betcha.
Nice meeting you. Best of luck.
Good luck, man.
Thank you.
It's funny, not one phone call. Everybody wants to pick. Well, we don't have anything to really move up for. That's the thing.
Hello. Yes. Right now we're looking at making the pick. Yeah.
No, not right now.
Hello. Hey, Doug. How you doing? Probably. What do you got in mind? What's your second? Yeah, I don't think so, but I'll get back to you if you have interest. Okay. Thanks, Doug.
San Jose offered their first, 49th, and third for our 14th. I said no. Value chart says it's a good deal by the hair.
It's not worth it. They don't have a third.
Hello.
Maybe next year, Dina.
Oh, next year.
Maybe.
I'd still say no, but I'll think about it. I'll get back to you, Doug. Thanks.
What?
20 and 2 seconds, get our fourth back. Hello. Yeah. Hey, Darcy, how you doing? Well, what do you have in mind?
Huh? That sounds like
52.
A good deal.
Not for that, no. Okay. I'd consider it. Let me get back to you.
311.
Okay.
311.
Thanks.
285. 735.
Buffalo would consider it for 38. Move back two spots and do 38.
The other side, 130.
Who are they after?
Hello. Yeah.
The math says you do that deal.
And you have 21. I actually have a better deal on the table. Okay, thanks.
Okay, hold on, we gotta write this down. Buffalo offered
18 and possibly 38. He's not sure if he'd do it.
You guys think they're all chasing Domi? Or who are they chasing?
Could be.
Toronto could be
phenomenal. Both the San Jose and Buffalo are more value to us.
So the next pick now belongs to the Phoenix Coyotes. Their last two first-round picks have been the sons of former NHL players. They took Henrik Samuelsson in 2012 and Connor Murphy in 2011. They could make it three in a row, possibly. Max Domi is sitting there, Ty Domi's son, who is rated in this neighborhood for the draft. So maybe Phoenix goes back and drafts the sons of players that they know. And of course, this is the old Winnipeg Jet franchise, and Ty Domi did play for them.
Phoenix Coyotes are proud to select from the London Knights of the OHL, Max Domi.
There it is. Three straight.
Hello. Okay. Buffalo passed.
That's who they wanted. So. They wanted him.
So should we go to 20? I think we just stick to our pick.
Stick with our pick?
Yeah.
Take Wendler.
That's who you guys want. Told you who we're going to get.
You were right. We're getting 14.
Well, the next selection in the 2013 draft belongs to the Columbus Blue Jackets. And this is interesting in a number of respects. It's the first draft for the first European GM in NHL history, in Jarmo Kekäläinen, who has a great track record going back to his days in Ottawa. And Jarmo Kekäläinen hopes to put his stamp on this team. He already has with a couple of big deals, and now he gets his first crack in the draft. And Pierre, you worked with Jarmo for a long time in Ottawa.
Yeah, I'm a big fan of Jarmo Kekäläinen. I think he'll hit a home run here for Columbus. The other thing, and you talked about it, Gord, they still have two more first-round picks. He will be one of the more creative general managers in the National Hockey League.
Columbus Blue Jackets are proud to select from Djurgården, Sweden, Alexander Wennberg.
Reichel.
The goal scorer.
Florida Reichel skating really good.
Like, sorry?
Central. I think what's where they go? Very good? Is that the highest? Or excellent?
They have
excellent.
A very good skating.
They have a very good.
He tends to chase the puck a little bit around. Like when the game's ramped up, is it a fair assessment to say that he. It looks like he's always kind of chasing.
That's coaching.
Is it more of his skating style and his effectiveness to get around the ice that's in question? That doesn't really matter if you can get there.
No. He's, yeah. I mean, he's got that leadership ability where he's going to drag people into the fight. Does the thing the right way. I mean, I think if we walked out of the draft with one of the three first, with one of the either Lazar or Reichel, with whatever pick, we've addressed a huge area for us as far as character and willing to compete in one of those guys.
So San Jose, then Columbus, then Detroit is the order projected right now as Tim Burke steps to the mic.
San Jose selects Mirko Mueller from Everett.
Baby,
that's good. I like that. I like that a lot.
Yeah,
I like it a lot. He's got. I think he's got a Lazar type of character. He's a tough kid.
Oh, yeah.
He can score. Yeah.
Hey, Bass. Preferred parking now there. Preferred parking.
Preferred parking at the Windsor Arena.
Yeah. You know how hard it is to get a spot there.
I think he has top two on upside. He's got 90 points every year. Hello. Yeah. Nope. We're making the pick. Thanks.
Are you sure? It wasn't.
Get to the point.
Hey?
I didn't even listen to what he had to offer. I guess we're making this.
Who was it though?
It was, Burge.
Who's going to make the announcement?
Kaz.
You're making another speech or?
Huh?
Are you going to make another speech?
Go.
You know, I get booed. You know, I get booed again.
They weren't bad.
No,
I thought they were
going right.
to kill me.
Yeah.
It's beautiful. Huh?
I'm fired up about this one.
So am I.
Yeah, I'm fired up about this.
It's fun.
Yeah. He's got bigger upside than myself because he can score.
That's okay.
I mean, I can score too, but he's bigger. And I don't mind skating. I don't. He's not slow at all.
It's just a hockey player.
Yeah.
guys into the fight every night.
19th pick in this year's draft belongs to the Columbus Blue Jackets. This is part of the haul they got for Rick Nash from the New York Rangers. So for Columbus, after they selected Alexander Wennberg from Sweden with the 14th overall pick, a chance to come back at number 19 with this selection. So Jarmo Kekäläinen and company have some assets to work with and believe that over the course of an 82-game season, Columbus might very well have made the playoffs the way they were coming on in the last month of the year.
Let's remember, they're moving to the Eastern Conference. They're getting out of that tough Central Division in the Western Conference. They're in a real good position going forward. If I'm a fan of the Columbus Blue Jackets right now, I'm really excited. There's Paul Kastrom.
Columbus Blue Jackets are proud to select from the Windsor Spitfires, Kirby Reichel.
Well, Bobby Bugner is a former member of the Columbus Blue Jackets, and he is part owner of the Windsor Spitfires where Kirby Reichel plays.
Big kid, huh?
He's a big kid.
John Davidson, Kirby, and we're excited. All right.
Congratulations.
Congratulations, kid.
Congratulations. You're gonna love it there.
Okay, take a step forward.
Who's got multiples in the second?
I bet you it's McCarron.
What about 38? Is he still with Buffalo?
Yeah.
They have 38 and 52, Buffalo.
We don't want to move back to 38, do we? No, it's too far.
Why are you thinking this?
Well, if we go back and we can still maybe get Dono in the early second.
Yeah. I don't think
but if he's 20th on our list, I mean, that's a late first. I don't know if you want to take a chance and move him back 11 spots. Hello, Craig. Jarmo calling. If our guy's gone at 27, would you have interest in that pick for your 2 seconds? Okay. Thanks, Craig. Bye. Doubtful. Not a lot of movement. Edmonton just said no. Buffalo.
Buffalo was 38
and 52. Darcy, if our guy's gone, would you have interest in 27 for your 38 and 52? Okay, thanks. 38 and 52, they're thinking about it if our guy's gone. But we're taking the 20 on our list. I like this pick, honestly. How many times do you get this young kid playing in the Men's World Championship? I haven't seen it very many
times.
We're
going down, right?
Yeah.
You guys liked him, huh?
Yeah.
You liked him?
Good World Junior.
Kind of a jack of all trades forward.
Has top six potential.
What? He's a skill kid. Skill.
Yeah. Has top six upside.
So that means computer.
And he's been playing the Men's World Championships. You're not that far
three,
from.
We got three picks away.
Yeah. You're not that far away from. And that intrigues me because he's played KHL and he's played Men's World Championships. Whereas some of these kids play Junior A. It's a huge jump to next level. This guy's already there. He's.
Good to go, gentlemen.
No.
Turn your books.
from Bratislava, Marco Dano.
Thank you. That was last time.
Okay. Well, if you change your mind, you're welcome back.
We'll work on it, but I don't know if the...